Alright, good morning everyone. So my name is Nathan Simonsidis. I'm from Insertion Games Lab from Monash University, Australia. And today I'm going to tell you about something called Neonumina and how it augmented the communication of emotion. Now, so what is Neonumina? Well, to give some context, I'm currently working on my PhD. It's titled Understanding the Design of Integrated Consciousness Through Implicit Neural Interfaces. So essentially everything that Pedro just talked about, I'm looking at how that interacts with consciousness and how you can think of integration in terms of how integration can be used to connect people's consciousnesses together, or how we can share conscious experiences. And so, yeah, to do that, I have devised like these three research questions and which sort of seek to answer these three research questions through three different prototypes. So these being, how do we design neural interfaces to act with subjective experiences of consciousness? How do we design neural interfaces to augment the communication of subjective experiences of consciousness? And how do we design neural interfaces to interpersonally integrate subjective experiences of consciousness? Now, what Neonumina is a prototype that I designed to answer this second question. And so now, rather than telling you what it is and how it works, I'm just going to show you with this video.
People often find it difficult to communicate their emotions. We believe that interactive technology can help with this. We have designed a new system called Neonumina. Neonumina uses brain-computer interfacing and artificial intelligence to read one's emotions and presents them to others in mixed reality through head-mounted displays. Both participants see fractals representative of their emotions overlaid over their physical environment. Through studying how people use Neonumina in their homes, we found that its spatial-temporal, representational, and social properties allow for participants to experience emotion as something that is changeable, as objectively informative, and as a beyond natural form of communication. We intend that our work gives guidance towards a technological future of empathy and unity.
Okay, so the design of Neonumina was first inspired by literature in neuroscience and psychology discussing the mechanisms of exchange of information between humans. The main takeaway that we got from here is while language is our primary means of information exchange, it has a lot of trade-offs that place limitations on how much information can be conveyed, while also being subject to misinterpretation. And meanwhile, there's also evidence that humans do have the cognitive bandwidth to take in additional information, we just don't use it. So we looked to research in neuroscience, emotion mapping, and biomimicry to find ways to encode emotional information without language. So this led us to the use of fractals, color, movement, and proximity to encode emotional information. We then took the principles underlying neurofeedback, namely that representation of brain activity can inform you about brain activity and allow you to change it, and modified it to make it interpersonal, hence the use of EEG. This outward modification of neurofeedback was completed through the lens of human-computer integration, so drawing specifically from Steve Mann's humanistic intelligence, which informed the adoption of AR to mediate the interpersonal communication of an emotional reality. So in practice, this was achieved through taking brain activity through an EEG and then passing it through machine learning algorithms to come to a classification of that person's concurrent affective state. With these classifications, we drove the generation of fractal swarms that followed and manifested themselves around that person for themselves and others to see. So to help us understand the resultant experiences of using Neonumina, we conducted an in-the-wild study in which the system was deployed to five pairs of participants. And during this time, participants used Neonumina at will for 3 days within their own homes. At the beginning and conclusion of the participation, we took measures of emotional competence. You probably know of this as emotional intelligence. And participants also kept diaries documenting their time with Neonumina, And lastly, we interviewed participants at the conclusion of their involvement in the study. Now, what this data told us is, first of all, in looking at the questionnaire data, we found a significant increase in interpersonal emotional regulation. So people found it easier to regulate or change the emotions of the people that they were interacting with. And then through the thematic analysis of the qualitative data, we came to three themes. So the first of these themes is spatial temporal actualization. So this theme of spatial temporal actualization concerns how emotion changed or did not change over time and how it's manifested within the participants' world. So the holographic manifestation of emotion helped participants conceive of emotion as a tangible thing, which led them to experiment with different stimuli to better learn how they can regulate theirs and their partner's emotion. So a quote from this is, one participant said, "I wanted to see if smoking a small joint would change how they reacted. I think it increased my stress levels, which seemed to be reflected in the numinal activity, with them being far more active both in time and space afterwards." I like this one because they point out time and space like specifically, which was very interesting. Next is objective representation. So there was a theme of it described how participants encoded and decoded the emotional information as representation, allowing for emotion to be expressed as information, either about themselves or their partner. So in expressing emotion as information, it allowed them to take in how they were feeling from a third person perspective. So this was a third person perspective, both from the individual and third person from like the group itself. So emotion was experienced as declarative, with participants describing perceptions of the system being a mirror into the mind or some infallible intermediate between individuals. An example of this is, one participant said, they gave an example of them thinking, "I think I'm feeling pretty good. Let's put on the neo-numinous for a little and see if I'm actually feeling good or if I'm just tricking myself that I'm doing good." And lastly, we have the theme of preternatural transmission. So this concerned the connections between individuals, the system, and their surroundings, and their social context, and the flow of information between these connections. So through this theme, we came to an understanding that neo-numina enabled participants to experience communication of emotion as some form of supernatural ability, which gave them sensory insight and access to information they otherwise could not have. So this went just beyond accessing their partner's emotional state, but participants were also reporting the ability to make inferences about things in their context based on their own or their partner's fractals, demonstrating like an emergent sense of extended abilities of perception. So one example of this is one participant said, "It enabled me to monitor seemingly drastic changes in their emotion, even as they affirmed to me that it was in fact okay for me to keep playing music." So they were playing a guitar, looked at their partner was like, "Oh, you know, it's totally fine." But the fractals were betraying that that was actually not the case. And there's another example where two participants were playing like a card game, and they're saying, this other person wearing the HoloLens can see my reaction to the cards that I can only see. So it gave them more information about the card game. So learning from this, we've devised a set of design strategies to in implementing these results in your own emotion communication systems for like designers building them in the future. So like we go extensively into this in the paper. I'm running out of time now, so I'll just leave it at that. And then going beyond neo-numina, so for my PhD, I'm currently building my framework of integrated consciousness, which this and the previous study that I have conducted has informed. And the next step is a system that I'm designing now called Synet, which is looking at how we can integrate, interpersonally integrate consciousness, not through some sort of like symbolic representation like in neo-numina, but through direct neural stimulation, through transcranial direct stimulation. So hopefully this gets into Chi next year and you'll all be able to see me talk about that then. But until then, thank you for listening. And if there's anything I'm hoping you take home after this, it's the notion that through technology, one can access and hopefully one day fully experience the subjective consciousness of another. Thank you.